Good morning, shooting fans, and welcome to the finals hall here in Munich, Germany, where we're kicking off today's events with 50-meter rifle-prone men. I'm Hillary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having USA's prone shooter Connor Davis here with me today. Welcome, Connor, and thank you for joining me again this week.
Thank you for having me.
You're becoming one of my very favorite guest commentators, by the way. Very willing to sit down next to me and go through this. So we've got our eight finalists for today. Why don't we tell people watching at home what we're going to be seeing?
First off, we have Ole Christian Bryan of Norway. He finished seventh earlier this year in Fort Benning.
Yeah, we'll have a chance to go over the finals in just a second, but if you can just explain what we'll be seeing for the final. What does it consist of?
Very similar to the air rifle final, you start off with a three-shot series, two of them, in a minute 50, I believe. Once six shots are taken, it moves to single shots. And after the first two single shots, we have our first elimination. And then so far after that, every two shots, so gold and silver and then bronze.
And as you were saying, you know, before with the 10-meter event that we saw the other day, the series of shots are probably the most important to get started off really strong. Is that right?
Very, get your points kind of built up a little bit, so that way you're not trying to fight all the way through. That way you have a little bit of a cushion. You can not relax, but you can kind of take it a little easy, but keep the gas pedal down.
And right now the gentlemen are going through some sighting and preparation time. What does that consist of? What, for people that haven't ever seen shooting before, what exactly are they doing?
Really getting their bodies, comfortable and getting the position comfortable and making sure the gun works and that it's sighted in. I mean, we're indoors here, so wind's not a factor, sun's not a factor, all that stuff. Really just getting comfortable and making sure they're putting them in the tin rig.
Now, just for your own personal preference, do you prefer to have a covered finals hall or do you prefer to shoot in the open?
To be indoors, scores will definitely be higher. I mean, obviously that's what we want.
Right.
But to make it, you know, a little more like the match. I like outdoors, like at Fort Benning, it's both match and the final are both outdoors. There's no really personal preference. It just sometimes that's how it is, and other times you gotta stay outside, but it's fine.
And just as a reminder, with these new finals format, everyone's starting off with zero after qualification, so it's anybody's game. And like you were saying, it is in this closed finals hall, so we will see really pretty high scores here. You know, 50 meters, that's a long distance to be shooting.
Yeah, that's a good piece.
And we're seeing right now for the sighting times, 10.9, 10.7, 0.86, all in the 10 range.
There will be a lot of 10s in this final, I mean, especially with some of the best prone shooters that we've ever seen, so.
It's true, we have a nice mix. We've got some mix of gentlemen that haven't really seen a whole lot and some gentlemen that we've seen a whole lot. Olympic Games medalists and... But, you know, as we've been seeing this week, you just don't know until the last shot who's going to be on the highest step of the podium.
Nope, it can change just like that.
Who would you put your money on?
Got to go with the teammate, Matt. he's been shooting really well lately, so definitely got to pick him. But if it wasn't him, definitely have to pick Henri. We were teammates in college, so he's number two.
Were you really teammates in college?
Yeah,
oh, both great.
Both went to University of Kentucky.
Yeah.
He graduated last year, so.
So probably a pretty close friend of yours, then.
Yeah, yeah. Good friends.
Really, really good guy, and he's been shooting extremely well.
Yeah, this year, well, last year especially, and I mean, even the start of this year at Fort Benning, he's been on a tear, so.
And it's pretty cool to see Warren Potent, he's back in the game. If I remember correctly, he said he was in Fort Benning, he made it into the final there. Mm-hmm. So this is pretty cool that he's back into it.
Yep.
He had a couple of years there where he wasn't quite making it into the final after qualifications, but God, the guy never gives up.
No.
And he's a real legend to the prone event, without a doubt.
30 seconds.
In just a couple seconds, we're going to have a chance to introduce our finalists. So what do we have here? We've got the sighting and preparation time is now finished, and we'll have a chance to introduce these guys. The nice thing about prone is they don't have to stand up and see the audience to be introduced. They can just stay in position, turn their heads. That way they don't have to go through this whole thing again.
Yes, it's very, very fortunate.
The shooting range here in Munich. The finals competition for the 50-meter rifle prone men's event will now begin. It is my pleasure to present to you the finalists.
So on firing point A, representing Norway, we have Ole Christian Brenn.
Yes, he was the seventh place finisher at Fort Benning earlier this year.
So he's probably very hungry to make it onto the podium today. On firing point B, representing Germany, we've got Henri Junghaenel.
Yes, he won the gold earlier this year at Fort Benning, and gold last year in Changwon.
Also happens to be shooter of the year for the year 2013. Firing point C, representing Australia, we have got Warren Potent.
Yes, he was the bronze medalist in the Olympic Games in 2008 in Beijing.
Unbelievable talent. He's got so many medals on his athlete's presentation card that we've got in front of us. On firing point D, representing the United States of America, your teammate, Matthew Emmons.
Yes, he was the gold medalist in Athens in 2004 and the silver medalist in the Olympic Games in Beijing.
I have to say he's pretty much the golden boy, wouldn't you say? On firing point E, representing Denmark, we have Stefan Olsen.
He had a sixth place finish earlier this year at Fort Benning.
On firing point F, representing the People's Republic of China, Liu Gang.
He got the silver medal earlier this year at the Fort Benning World Cup.
And that was the first World Cup medal that he's gotten, so you have to keep an eye on this guy. On firing point G, representing Norway, we have Odd Arne Brekna.
He finished sixth place in Milan in 2012 and 13th in 2012 in the London Olympics.
And then on firing point H, also representing the People's Republic of China, we have Zhao Shengbo.
He finished 34th place in the Fort Benning World Cup earlier this year.
So it's never a surprise to see Chinese people in the final. They've got two in today's final. And they've got a very strong team, as I always say. But it's a real interesting mix, I think, Connor, of shooters and athletes here today. And it would be, of course, you have to put your money on your teammate. But it's going to be interesting to find out exactly what happens here. We're going to be going into the first series of shots. Again, they've got 140 seconds to shoot at three targets. And that's enough time, you think?
Oh, yes, especially in prone. I mean, you can get shots off very quickly.
Actually, it's 100 seconds for each shot, each series of shot, followed by single shots to be shot within 30 seconds. So we'll see how this goes with these guys. It's been really great here during this World Cup. The finals hall has just been completely cram-packed.
Yeah,
standing room only. Yeah, really good.
And it's really loud.
It was surprising, actually. You know, you see that during World Cup finals that they want to get people a little bit wound up, but they've been doing it on their own here, and it's been really great. I'm not sure how it's really affected the shooters, but I think it's been great. .10 for Zhao.
Very good start.
And Junghaenel with a 10.0. Tell us a little bit, Connor, about what you're waiting for before you shoot.
Well, indoors, I mean, you don't have to look at the flags. You're not trying to read the wind or anything. So you're really trying to just to set up the best possible shot you can. Make sure your heart rate's kind of lowered. Your breathing's good. I mean, you don't want to hold the breath too long, but I mean, you want to make sure that you get a really nice solid hold. And the biggest thing for me especially is just a nice trigger squeeze. I'm just trying to make the gun go off without moving the gun.
Mm-hmm.
So but expect me, like I said, indoors. That's pretty much all we're worried about is making sure you're executing good shots.
And how do you do that? How do you slow down your heartbeat?
For me, I take really deep breaths and I count backwards from 10. I don't know why backwards. That's just something I started in. So yeah, just deep breaths and count. And try and get my heart on beat with me counting.
All right, let's take a look now at the standings. After the first series, we have got Warren Potten in first place with only 1/10 of a point behind him. We have Zhao. Zhao's teammate is right behind him, Liu. He's 2/10 of a point behind. We have Bryn, only 1/10 of a point behind Liu. And it's a really tight fight. We've got a tie for fifth place between Emmons and Junghaenel.
Competition series. Start.
Now, Potent finishing off that last series with a 10.9. That is definitely the way to climb up the scoreboard without a doubt. Starting off the 10.0, and you could see what you were just describing earlier. He was taking a couple deep breaths, and then there was no movement. 10.1 for Zhao. Followed by 10.3. Teammate Liu. Excellent, 10.7 to finish off. Olsen, 2 10.4s in a row. That's the way to go for Matthew Emmons. 10.4, 10.9. You can't get any better than that, followed by a 10.4. Waiting now for Junghaenel's last shot. It's a 10.2.
Now at the end of our
so let's take a look now. We've got Emmons now, who has climbed up into first place. He is down to that by 2/10 of a point. We have Liu in second place. And Potent has now moved down to third place. He's only 1/10 of a point behind. You know, this is just amazing right now. It's just 1/10 of a point separating almost everybody. We get down to Bryn, who's in seventh place, and he's 1.3 of a point behind. Olsen is in the hot seat right now. He's only 7/10 of a point behind Bryn. He could make that up, couldn't he? Or is that kind of tough?
In prone, it's awful hard. But, I mean, not undoable.
So two shots to go, and then eighth place will be eliminated. Who's it going to be? Is it going to be Olsen? Is it going to be Bryn? No idea, but as you were saying, it is kind of tough. For Bryn. Olsen with a 10.0.
Stop.
Rekna, 10.4.
So that's seven competition shots.
So we've got Liu. Now, who has moved up into first place by 2/10 of a point over his teammate, Zhao. Bryn is 2/10 of a point behind him and tied up right now with Junghaenel. Emmons has now moved down to fifth place, only 2/10 of a point behind him. I think this eighth place we have already in the bag, wouldn't you say?
It's 1 point.
Yeah. Stefan Olsen from Denmark coming off of a 10.0. With a 10.4. Bryn 10.6. Nice shooting there.
Ladies and gentlemen, after that eighth competition shot, we have our first.
We do have our eighth place person. We've got Stefan Olsen from Denmark. He will be eliminated now. We've got Liu in first place by 7/10 of a point over Bryn. Emmons has now moved up into third place. He's only 1/10 of a point behind Bryn. And Brechna, sorry. And we've got Bryn in seventh place right now. He's 8/10 of a point behind Potent. So it's Bryn who really is in the hot seat right now. We'll see how his last two shots go and find out if he can stay in the game.
Start.
That is going to change things around. You can tell he's not at all happy about this. He's just coming off winning the silver in Fort Benning. Brechna at 10.0.
So after that shot, the highest score of the round was Henri Junghaenel with a 10.7.
All right, so things have changed around once again. We have got Zhao now in first place. Only 1/10 of a point behind him. We've got Emmons and Junghaenel tied up for second place. Actually, it's a three-way tie for second place. Also, Liu.
Extremely close.
Still 8/10 of a point behind is Bryn. And this is going to be the deciding factor for seventh place. Potent 10.4 for Bryn.
So,
and things are
going
to change around a little bit. But first, we got to say goodbye to Bryn. Ole Christian Bryn from Norway is finishing off in seventh place. We had Zhao, who shot a 10.9. You can't get any better than that, and that's how you move up the scoreboard. He is now in first place by 4/10 of a point over Matthew Emmons. 1/10 of a point behind him is Liu. Junghaenel is 1/10 of a point behind him. Right now we've got Brechna, who is in sixth place. This is doable. He's only 1/10 of a point now behind Potent.
Yes, with two shots, yes, that's very easy to make up.
Zhao coming off of a perfect 10.9. With a 9.9. Nine. 10.5 for Emmons.
Stop.
And so things have once again changed around. We have Brechna still in sixth place. He's 3/10 of a point now behind Potent. And Liu now has moved up into first place, overtaking his teammate. Emmons still in second place. He is 1/10 of a point behind Liu. Brechna now has only 3/10 of a point behind Potent. This is going to be the deciding shot.
Start.
It's really a fight here to stay in the game between Potent and Brechna. 10.6. A 10.0 for Potent. And that has put him now in sixth place. You can see that he was not very pleased with that, but you know, he's made it into two finals in 2014. Very respectable. Brechna has now stayed in the game, and we've got Emmons and Zhao now tied up for first place. 3/10 of a point behind them, we have got Liu. So once again, Brechna is in the hot seat, is a half point behind Junghaenel. Half a point? Connor, what do you think?
Henry's a very good prone shooter, very good final shooter. I feel like he'll definitely stay ahead.
It's a lot of pressure to put on Brechna. You know, he's been in the elimination category, let's say, or a position for quite a while now, and he keeps on making it up. Wow, Liu, a 10.8. 10.34 at Junghaenel.
After that competition shot, the highest score of the round.
So Brechna is still, excuse me, half a point behind Junghaenel. We've got Emmons, who is now taken on first place. He's 1/10 of a point ahead of Liu. And it's one more shot to find out who's going to end up in fifth place. Half a point is probably going to be quite difficult to make up.
For the next competition shot, Liu. Start.
.10 for Bruckner. Oh. Emmons just shot a 9.7.
Stop.
Very nice. 10.6 for Junghaenel. And this will confirm the fact that we're going to have to say goodbye to Bruckner.
So, ladies and gentlemen, after that shot, the highest score of the round was, two people, Henri Junghaenel and Liu Gang with 10.6.
So things have changed around on the scoreboard.
And unfortunately, we have to say goodbye.
We've got to say goodbye to Arne Brekne from Norway.
To Arne Brekne.
We do have
in
now in first place Liu from the People's Republic of China. Second place is going to Zhao, his teammate. Junghaenel has moved up into third place, and Emmons is now in the hot seat. He's moved down to fourth place, and these are the two shots that are the most difficult. We know that Emmons can get back on track. 0.2 in two shots, that is doable.
Very. And he's one of the best competitors. He's not going to go out without swinging.
.10 for Liu.
Stop. So after that single shot,
after this shot, we've got Liu still in first place. He's now a half a point behind his teammate Zhao. Emmons is in fourth place. He's a half a point behind Junghaenel.
Lead to 0.5 difference between Zhao Shengbo in second position. Henri Junghaenel is currently in third position, and Matthew Emmons down in fourth position at this time. This next shot will decide.
You know, anything can happen. Connor, you're sweating bullets up here for your teammate.
Yeah, I don't feel Henry would have to make a mistake, and I don't think he's going to do that.
No.
Stop.
The whole focus here is on Matthew Emmons. .10. I'm just waiting now for Junghaenel. .10.
So
that wraps up fourth place. From the USA, Matthew Emmons finishing up in fourth place.
We now have our three
So we've got our three finalists right now. We've got Liu, Zhao, and Junghaenel. Junghaenel is in third place right now, half a point behind Zhao.
Competition shot, Liu. Start.
.10 from Zhao.
He is definitely feeling it right now.
He definitely is. A .10 for his debut, and just waiting on Junghaenel, a .10. Very, very nice shooting there.
After that single shot,
we have got
Zhao
in first place. 3/10 of a point behind him is teammate Liu, and 3/10 of a point behind him, we've got Junghaenel.
In second place at the moment, we have Liu Gang and Henri Junghaenel in third position. This next shot will decide that bronze medal.
Going on now to the bronze medal.
For the next competition shot,
3/10 of a point?
Loaded.
Come on. He can do that, right?
Oh, yeah, he can do it.
Start.
And 10.5 for Junghaenel. And that is the determining factor. So we have our bronze medalist today, representing Germany, Henri Junghaenel.
I'm sure he's still probably pleased.
I'm sure that he is too.
Two World Cups, two medals.
Yeah. We've got an extremely tight match now between the two gentlemen from the People's Republic of China. We've got Liu with 1/10 of a point advantage over his teammate Zhao. Two shots to go to find out who's going to be on the highest step of the podium. 1/10 of a point separating Liu from Zhao.
Start.
Ooh, 9.7 and a 10.6. That puts a nice 8/10 of a point between the two. We've got Zhao, who has now moved up into first place.
That has now jumped him up into first position. There's now 0.8 difference.
Zhao has never entered into a final round of a World Cup before. He placed 34th in Fort Benning. And somebody we're going to have to keep our eyes on in the future, that's for sure.
Shooting very good right now.
Start.
This is it. This is for the gold. Republic of China, we have Zhao Shengbo. Fantastic shooting, really, really great. And let's see if we can see his teammate, silver medalist. There he is, our silver medalist, Liu Gang from the People's Republic of China. Both gentlemen put up a really great fight, and it was really good and great to see this final today. Connor, thank you so much again for joining me today.
No problem.
It's always a pleasure to have you near me. I prefer to have you out there in front of me.
Oh, yeah.
And your time is coming. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
That's good.
Please welcome your medalists. The medals will be presented by Wanda Chu, chairman of the rifle jury. The bronze medal representing Germany goes to Henri Junghaenel. Your silver medalist representing the People's Republic of China goes to Liu Gang. Gold medalist representing the People's Republic of China, Zhao Shengbo. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the People's Republic of China. Please give your athletes a huge round of applause.